So it is a periodic rectangular function. Its value is, what is its value? It is A for all values of, suppose you represent it by X, then for all values of X, it is A between the interval from minus t by 2 to plus t by 2, and it is 0 anywhere. And this is given in terms of time domain. The same signal can be represented using a frequency domain. How do you represent it? You integrate it between the limits minus infinity to plus infinity x of t e power minus j omega t. And when you integrate this, what you are getting is, this is the integral. So what I am doing is, I will write it again if you are not able to see. You are integrating minus infinity to plus infinity x of t e to the power minus j omega t. This is the step here. Now, this minus infinity to plus infinity interval is replaced here in this step. It is replaced between minus t by 2 to plus t by 2. Why? Because other side, outside this boundary, since it is 0, we are not considering, we are only considering this interval. So, between these intervals, the value being equal to A, we are writing A e power minus A e power minus j omega t dt. And your interval is between minus 2 by 2 to t by 2. So, I am just writing the same thing here. Little broader. Minus t by 2. Please copy this along. A e power minus j omega t dt. And that is equal to, what is integral of A power minus j omega t? It is A bar e power minus j omega t divided by j omega, isn't it? So this can be written as equal to, A can be taken out of the integral. It is A bar minus j omega by minus j omega. And apply the limits from minus t by 2 to plus t by 2, and when you do this, my 1 by minus j is plus j. So what will you get here? Substitute in place of t e power minus j t by 2 and plus t by 2. And you already have a relation e power minus plus j omega minus of e power minus j omega is sine. So I think you will get this. Just tell me whether you are getting this relation. E power minus j omega t by 2. Minus e power minus j omega minus, so it becomes plus, plus t by 2, plus t by 2 into that a j by y. So that, what value you getting here? Can I write omega is equal to 2 pi by t? So if I write omega is equal to 2 pi by t, then j omega t by 2 becomes what? J into 2 pi by t into t by 2. So it is e power 2j pi. E power minus 2j pi. So this becomes e power minus 2j pi minus e power plus 2j pi a j by y. So then this becomes once again simplify this, then this when you simplify what you get is e power minus j, what will it be? It is cos 2 pi minus j sin 2 pi minus cos 2 pi minus j sin 2 pi. Cos pi is minus 1, this is plus 1, this is 0, this is 0. So this is 2 pi plus 1 cos 2 pi j sin 2 pi. This is minus cos 2 pi. And when you replace this, the entire thing can be replaced with this expression. So what you are getting here is finally 2a pi omega into sin omega t by 2. So that is what is this function that we are representing. And this function is referred to as, this function is referred to as sin x by x, which is SINC function, sync function. So the mathematical support we are taking it from the Fourier series. And this is what you are getting as this. So just write down. This spectrum is of the form sin x by x, which is known as sync function. Let us see what are the attributes of this. It has infinite concentrated mainly in the information is concentrated mainly in the low frequency range. So this is the first attribute. The information is basically concentrated only in the low frequency range. Then BC carrier wave has impulses at FC and minus FC. That is the second observation. The product of the two results in ASK is in tandem. So this is what is observations that have been made from this graph. That the entire information is localized in the low frequency range. And carrier has two impulses, one at FC plus FM and one is at FC minus FM. So therefore, at this point of time, since you are able to get the product, we have generated an amplitude modulating signal. Next, once you have modulated it and transmitted it at the transmitting station, it reaches what is known as a receiver. And what is the role of a receiver? At the receiver, what is expected to do is, to recover signals, to recover the original signal. Recovery of the original signal is known as demodulation or detection, and this happens at what is known as a signal. This happens at the receiver. This is a very important concept here. There are two ways in which detection can take place. One is called the coherent method. The other one is called the non-coherent. The coherent one is complex. The coherent one is complex, but it is of good quality, better performance. the non-coherent is lesser in its performance. What exactly is coherence and what is non-coherence? Coherence means, in optics or in general physics, coherent refers to two waveforms in same phase. The non-coherent refers to, this is one of the definitions. The non-coherent refers to the two waves which may not be in the same phase. It is out of phase. By what angle they are out of phase? Phase is angle. By what angle they are out of phase depends on the application to which you are using. So let us see. First, the coherent, which is of good quality and good performance, then the non-coherent. For a coherent method of detection, this is the block diagram. Copy down this and let me know after you finish.